What's up, guys? Let's do some complex puzzles. This puzzle, I can take the rook, say check, and then what to do next? So let's do first move, first check. And then I was thinking maybe I should give a second check, but the first problem you see is that pawn f4. Dealing with check easily, but after pawn f4 I play rook f5 and checks. I check at e5 and then pawn f4 forks my queen and rook. Then I play rook f5. If he takes my queen with the pawn, I take his queen. He also doesn't have any valuable check. If he doesn't take, then the game is over. It's mate soon. Now, for example, he should move the queen somewhere and then it's mate soon. But the point is that suppose he takes, I take, and he has two dangerous pawns. He has two dangerous pawns that are not easy to stop. Right? I can stop one of the pawns with rook, but the second one also, because his knight also joins the defense. So maybe the best is just to attack the g pawn. Suppose I attack the g pawn with the queen. Queen b2. I'm threatening mate. Is there a defense for it? I don't see. Let's do it. Okay. Again, take the knight. Is there a defense for it? I don't see any defense. So let me take it. I go up. Oh, okay. There wasn't defense. I thought too much about exchanging queens. Maybe I shouldn't think about making life easy by easy moves. Here I see one easy direction. I say check, then goes down. I say check, goes down. I take the rook with check. No, I say check, goes down. I take the pawn with check, goes to e8. I take the rook with check, goes up. I take the other rook, then it starts to perpetual check me. But I don't need to take the other rook, right? I give it first check, I give it second check, I give it third check. No, I can stop the perpetual check by queen h7. Right, because if I take the rook, it's of course free, but if I take it, then I start to queen is not h7 but g7. I start to check at, for example, d5 d1, takes a pawn with check. I have nothing but place the rook on g2 and then says check again and so forth. So I can play queen here and defend my perpetual check. I should have played it faster to get more points, but it doesn't matter. I just want to explain it. Here, I see that I can attack the queen and perhaps deliver some nasty mating attack. Why not? What I'm saying is rook b2 attacking queen and then rook g2. Rook b2, queen goes somewhere. Where exactly? I can even, yeah, let's do this rook b2. Oh, it was wrong. What was it? Too complex. 3000 rated puzzle and lots of details. So I offer him rook exchange. I have a very good passed pawn. I play rook a4. If it takes my knight, I push the pawn and there's no way to defend. If it doesn't take my knight and takes the rook, I take back, then Again, he cannot take my knight because I push the pawn. Goes down. Goes down. And here is my problem. What's the idea and what I want to do next? Yeah, I think it's fine. Let's do it. Take the... Okay, it was much easier than I was expecting. So I can take the knight, of course, but if I take the knight, he has time to move the king away and additionally push his pawn after that. What else can I do? I can push my pawn, attack to his g pawn. If he takes with the knight, I take it, and then he takes with the pawn. No. Or I can take the h pawn. It takes, of course, there is no option actually in this case. It takes. Then I push the e pawn. But now this is too slow. So I take the knight. He takes the king. If I push the pawn at this moment, he should take. Then I take the h pawn. Yeah, it's true. Why not? Take the knight. Push the pawn. Take the h pawn. Go. Wow. Good. That was it. See you next time.